Hi everyone, I am Ashutosh Bhardwaj and today we will learn how to register the server onto the AnyPoint cloud platform and how to make a cluster, how to put monitoring, how to deploy your applications into the hybrid environment where you have a on-premises server and cloud running AnyPoint platform. So let's start. I have already created an account onto AnyPoint cloud platform. So what I will do is I will just log into this platform and we'll see what all options it will give. So right now, since we are here to register a server, we will go to the runtime manager. Of course, there are many components available onto the AnyPoint cloud. And that's a separate exercise altogether to know all of the components. But right now we will start with the servers. As you can see, there are few tabs here like applications, servers, alerts, virtual private clouds, and load balancers. Since there is no application deployed so far, that is why it is showing you there are no applications to show. I'll go to the servers tab since we have to register our on-prem server to the AnyPoint cloud. Now to register a server, first of all, the Mule runtime engine should be available in our server machine. So let me just go to the Mule runtime engine, what we have installed in our machine already. Let me show you how this look like. Sorry, I have clicked on something else. Let me just close all of this. Okay, now go to the Windows Explorer. I have installed the same in D, Ayush, and in Mule Enterprise Standalone 4.1.4. As you can see, there is a folder structure which constitutes the Enterprise edition of MuleSoft. So what we will do is we will just open the command prompt, go to D, Ayush, Mule runtime, and go to the bin directory of Mule runtime engine. Now to register this server, we will first check whether our server is running or not. So just type a command mule status. It will ask for the permission. We'll give the permission to it. As we can see, the server is not running yet, so it's okay, we are good to go. What we will do is we will go to the AnyPoint cloud platform, click on add server, we'll copy this command from the server and paste the same command in CMD. Now this server hyphen name should be replaced as whatever custom name I want to give to my server. So let me just type my local server, and if we are a Windows user, we have to remove these two characters. If we are a Linux user, then these two characters are fine. We will click on enter. It will try to run some commands over it and will show some kind of a log. At the end, it will communicate to AnyPoint Management Center, and the communication is a two-way communication, which is SSL enabled communication. So as we can see, the request is signed off and Mule agent configured successfully. So now we'll be able to see the same server into the MuleSoft cloud. Let me just go to here. As we can see, we have my local server. The status is created yet since we did not run the server so far. So let's just start this server by running a command mule start. Let us see what will happen. Again, it will ask for the permissions. Since my account is not an administrator account, that is why it is asking the permission every time. If you have an administrator account on your server, then it will not ask for the permissions. So it takes few seconds to get started. Till then, we will see what apps we have in this server. The apps are present into the apps folder. As we can see, there's an app which is named as BFS Check. We'll delete this app. so that there will be no match. And we are waiting for the server to start. While this server is running, let us open AnyPoint Studio so that we can create our own test application to deploy. Okay, so as you can see, the MuleSoft Enterprise Edition service has started. Now let's go to the cloud and see, this is a running server of MuleSoft. As you can see, the gateway version is 4.1.4, which is the same version which we are running as a runtime engine on my machine, on our server, and the agent version is 2.2.0. Now the agent is responsible to send all these statistics, whether the server is running or stopped, or deploying, or starting, or stopping, any kind of statistics, the agent is responsible to send it, right? We can go to the server and see the details. As you can see, it is showing you the CPU utilization as well as the heap memory and many other things. So let's create a simple application and let's deploy it to the server. While this studio is running, let us just create the cluster first. So what we will do is, we will go to the create cluster. We will type the name of the cluster, my local cluster. You can type any name, whatever you want. That's completely your choice. Now there are two kind of a cluster. Number one is unicast. Number second is multicast. A multicast and unicast clusters both have separate definition altogether. Okay, so define the name of your cluster. I typed my local cluster. Then pick cluster type. There are two kinds of a cluster. Number one is unicast, number two is multicast. Now a unicast cluster is totally depend on IP address of your machine. And a multicast cluster can only be built if all your nodes, all your machines are in the same network. If you have a cluster with different kind of a network, one server is running in network 1 and the second server is running in network 2, then you go for unicast cluster, because it totally depends on the IP address of your machine. A major drawback of unicast cluster is it needs a static IP. So if your machine after restart changes the IP address, it means it will lost its cluster properties. So as you can see, to add a server into the unicast cluster, the status of the server should be running first. If it is not running, then you will not be able to add it to the cluster. As you can see, whatever server we have registered so far, it is showing us as a select server. So we will select this server, we'll give the IP address of this server, and let us the port, let AnyPoint cloud auto discover the port. Since we have given all the configuration so far, now please note this warning. The warning says servers will be restarted and all agent plugin configs will be overwritten when the cluster is created. It means whenever you add a node or a server to a unicast cluster, you have to restart your servers. Otherwise, the server will not be part of the cluster. So we'll just click on create cluster. As you can see, the message is server cluster, my local cluster created successfully. The server will now restart to apply new settings. Now it will automatically start your server. You can see that it is disconnected so far because it is starting the server. We will go to the server tab again. We will not be able to find out the server now because the servers are the part of the cluster for us. So since it is disconnected, let us just go back and see the status of our server. We'll type the command mule status so that it will show us the status of the
server which is present on premises. Again, it will ask for the permissions. As you can see, the server is running, and the same is running here as well, because when I add this server to the cluster is automatically stop the server first and then restart the same, so that it will load its own configuration. So now, as you can see, your cluster is up and running. There is one server present in this cluster so far, which is my local server, and which is the primary node. The star says it is the primary node of this cluster. Now go to the AnyPoint Studio. We will just create a very simple application, maybe to print out something. Let me just close all the project, then we will create a new project, new Mule project. My application and finish. Okay, so we have just created a sample application where there is a single API, and it will request to get a employee list from some public platform, right? So what we will do is we will just create a jar file from this application. We will export, go to the Mule, go to AnyPoint Studio project to Mule deployable archive, click on next. Now we can choose any of the path, whatever we like. So I will just add this jar file to desktop with the name of check API. Now click on finish. What it will do is it will package your application into the deployable jar file, which you can deploy to the cluster directly. In the next 1 or 2 minutes, once this packaging is done, we will deploy it to the cluster what we have created so far. So let's wait for this to package in a jar file. It takes few minutes. Sometimes it takes more time because of internet connectivity, because my it is downloading some of the required libraries. It's exported, and we have a jar file present here named as check API. Now I'll go to the cluster, go to the application tab, okay, so we are now here to deploy the applications. Since there is no application so far, so we'll go to the server, we'll select our own cluster which we have created, then we will select applications tab, go to the setting. As you can see, there is no applications present so far. So we'll click on no application deployed, and it will open a wizard to deploy the application. So let me just write down any name to my application. As you can see in the deployment target, there are two options. Number one is the Cloud Hub, which is the cloud network of AnyPoint platform. And second is my local cluster, which we have just created. So we have to deploy it onto this my local cluster. So we'll select this cluster, and all the properties of this cluster will come here. Now we will choose file. Okay, so now we are here to deploy the application. Since I have restarted my cluster, it is showing as disconnected. So let's wait for a few minutes to get it restarted again. Once it is restarted, then we will go to deploy the application. It takes few minutes to restart again. Okay, now it is running. We'll go to the application tab, click on deploy application. We'll type any name of our choice. So I will type my local app. In the deployment target, there are two options. Number one is Cloud Hub. Number two is my local cluster. Since we have created the local cluster, so select my local selector, my local cluster. Then there are two options. Number one is get from sandbox. You can use this option if you want to copy the application from one environment to another. But right now our application is packaged into a jar and it is present on our own system. So we will click on choose file and upload file. Now go to the desktop. Since we have stored our application on desktop, we can see check API. Double click on it. Go to insight, enable the metadata option and click on deploy application. Now it will upload this application as a jar file and then deploy it to our server. As you can see, the apps folder of the server is empty right now. Once the application is deployed, you can find the same application into the apps folder of runtime engine. Let's wait for the application upload, and once it is uploaded, then we will see it into the action. As we can see the messages, my local app was uploaded successfully and is deploying. You can see the status is starting. So currently the Mule Anypoint Management Center has copied the application to the Mule Runtime Engine present on our server machine. As you can see in the apps folder. But the application is not present yet. So it is trying to start the application. Once it is started, the application will be copied here on this folder, the apps folder inside the Mule Enterprise standalone 4.1.4, which is the installation directory of our runtime engine. So it will take few minutes to actually deploy the application, and then we will see whether it present into the apps folder or not. And then we will put some alerts and some monitoring, some insights to this application, where we will be able to see whether our application performance is good or not good, or we have to add more servers, or we do not need any kind of a server. So let's just wait for a few more minutes to actually. So as you can see, the application status is started. Let's go to the runtime engine, go to the apps, and you can see my local app is already present here with this anchor file. Now let us see whether this application is working or not. Let me just run this command. I'm just hitting the API from the Postman, and here we go. We have verified that this particular application is working. So now what we will do is we will just try to open up some kind of insights and statistics for this application. So we will be able to see everything onto the Anypoint Cloud. Go to setting. Flow monitoring, we have to enable the same, apply changes, then go to insight, it is already metadata. So this is now okay, right? Now we will go to the insight tab. Here we will be able to see all the transactions which takes place here. So let me just make some transaction on this application so that it will generate some kind of a statistics data. And then we will monitor whether this data is useful for us or not. So I have made 5 API calls back to back. We'll see whether this data is reflecting here or not. It takes some time to get reflected. Here we go. We have found one transaction so far, which is completed. If you open up this transaction, you will see that there are message processor begin and everything. Now this begin and is equal to the number of operations present in our API. Go to the API, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 operations. You will see 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you can easily depict at which step your API is failing, if it is actually failing. We'll again refresh the page and see whether we have got more statistics or not. Yes, so we have got 6 transactions. We can see the processing time as well. We can see the actual timestamp present on that particular transaction. You can even filter all these insights with various filters, like if you want to see something with the transaction ID, or you want to see only the completed logs or only the failed items, failed APIs, or you can select the date time, like in last hour how many requests we have received, last 24 hours how many requests we have received and they are completed or they are failed or not, flow name, exception, or what kind of API are taking maybe more than 5 seconds, maybe more than 5 seconds. So you can filter all these using this filter present in this Anypoint Cloud platform. So this is all about the insights. Now the next step is to enable the monitoring and to enable the visualizer part of this Anypoint Cloud. Now go to the monitoring. Now to enable this monitoring, we have to first go to the settings. Since we have hybrid environment, so we need to click on hybrid. Then we have to select the environment and the server for which we want to enable the Anypoint monitoring. So we will select sandbox. On the sandbox, I have my local cluster. In the cluster, I have my local server, right? Once I did all these selections, I have to download the am.zip file and put the same into my mule home directory. So it will take 4 to 5 minutes to get downloaded. Now there are steps written here. Once this zip file is downloaded, we have to extract it. After extraction, it will create a new folder named as am. We have to go to the am folder and run this PowerShell command. Now PowerShell is different from command prompts. So we have to open the PowerShell and we'll type this command. Now this command is completely different for all kind of hybrid environments. This ID will get changed every time whenever you come onto this screen to register any kind of a server. Then once this command is completed, we have to restart our server. Once restarted, we will again go to the same folder, AM folder, and run one more command. After 5 minutes, we'll be able to see matrices into the AnyPoint monitoring dashboards. So let's wait for 20 to 21 seconds, minutes it is showing to download this am.zip file. Okay, so now as you can see, the am file is downloaded and will complete all other steps to get the monitoring and visualization started onto the AnyPoint platform. So we'll go to the downloads. I will copy this am.zip file and paste it to the home directory of my MuleSoft installation. Now this is my home directory. I have copied it here. Then I have to extract the same. As you can see, there is a folder am present in this particular installation. Now as mentioned here, we have to copy this command and paste the same into the PowerShell, because it's a PowerShell command. .ps indicates it's a PowerShell command. I have to go to cd into the am folder and run this command, right? So I will open the PowerShell. I will go to D, then Ayush as per my folder, then go to the mule home directory where I have just copied the, just extracted the AM folder. Now go to the AM folder. Now we are in the AM folder. What I have to do is I have to run this command here. It will ask you a question, do you want to use monitoring as a service? We'll type yes, we want to use it as a Windows service. Now the error is cannot be created due to the following error, which is access is denied because I did not open the PowerShell using the administrator platform. So let me just try to run it as administrator and follow the same steps. Go to D drive, then go to Ayush, go to MuleSoft, go to AM folder, and then run my command. Yes, we would like to use monitoring as a service. So as you can see, it's a success. So our this command is completed. The next step is the restart the server. So let's go to the command prompt and restart the server. So first I will stop. then I will start the same. Okay, now the server is started. The next step is to run one more command, cd into the AM folder again, and go to run this command into the Windows server. So we will again open the PowerShell and run this command. As you can see, it is showing as waiting for endpoint monitoring configuration. Then the configuration is ready and it restarted the endpoint monitoring file build service. It means now it is started. We'll go to the built-in dashboards. We can see we have this my local app present here in the sandbox environment. You can click on view. So as you can see, all these overview, inbound connections, outbound connections, performance, failures, JVM, infrastructure are the part of the Anypoint monitoring built-in dashboards. After some time, it will show you all the statistics here, like how much CPU it is utilized, how much memory is utilized, and all these things. It takes some time to get the statistics available for you. Then go to the visualizer. Now you do not need to perform any kind of other actions to see visualizer in action. As you can see, my local app is already present there. We can click inbound connections. There are zero connections so far for my local app. What we will do is we will just send some requests, so it will generate some statistics there. So let's wait for some time so the visualizer will be able to show you the insights what we have generated in this particular for this particular application. Meanwhile, go to the monitoring. We'll see if monitoring dashboard is showing the data. My internet is it is slow, that is why it is not showing. Otherwise, you will be able to see all the monitoring information here and all the visualizers for your APIs into the visualizer tool. So that's all about the session for today. We have learned how to register a server into the runtime manager, then how to run, how to stop, how to start this server and see the insights. Then we have learned about the cluster types, which is unicast and multicast, and we have created a unicast cluster as well. Then we have deployed an application named as MyLocalApp to the cluster, and we are able to see all the insights present in this particular application. We're able to filter all these things. Then we have scheduled the monitoring and visualizer part. So that's all for this particular session. Thank you so much for joining. Thanks a lot.